U.S. Missile Defense Agency, or MDA, has taken a major decision. Lockheed Martin has won a $17 billion contract to develop the next generation of interceptors to defend the United States against an intercontinental ballistic missile attack, the U.S. Missile Defense Agency said on Monday. The interceptor program is aimed at defeating current ballistic missile threats and future technological advances from countries such as North Korea and Iran. The multi-year missile contract covers the development of the Next Generation Interceptor (NGI) to modernize the Ground-Based Midcourse Defense (GMD) program. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the Next Generation Interceptor is critical for the U.S. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. GMD is the Ground-Based Midcourse Defense System developed by the U.S. to protect against ballistic missiles. It neutralizes incoming ballistic threats by engaging them during the midcourse phase of ballistic trajectory flight in space. Viewers may note that it's not meant to be used against aircraft or cruise missiles and is specifically meant for intermediate-range ballistic missile (IRBM) and intercontinental ballistic missile (ICBM) threats. Work on GMD began in the 1990s, and after about $40 billion in research and development costs, it was declared operational in 2004. The system has been bolstered with the deployment of new radar capabilities, such as the Long-Range Discrimination Radar (LRDR), to strengthen detection. The key components of the GMD system are 1. Sensors that include ground-based radars (GBR), upgraded early warning radars, and forward-based X-band radars (FB-XB), such as the sea-based X-band platform and the ANTPY-2, all developed by Raytheon. 2. Exo-Atmospheric Kill Vehicle (EKV) manufactured by Raytheon. It's designed to collide with the incoming missile to destroy it. 3. Ground-Based Interceptor (GBI) built by Orbital Sciences. All interceptors are kept in ground-based missile silos and are located in Fort Greely, Alaska, and Vandenberg Air Force Base, California. The GBI carries the EKV to the desired trajectory. 4. Battle Management Command, Control, and Communications developed by Northrop Grumman. While the SM-3 Block 2A, powered by Aegis BMD, can destroy intercontinental ballistic missile (ICBM) targets, GMD remains the best bet for defense against long-range ballistic missile threats. NGI is being engineered to handle more complex situations to be able to hit maneuverable targets. The objective is to upgrade and improve the current ground-based interceptors deployed in Fort Greely, Alaska, and Vandenberg SFB in California. In 2019, the Pentagon scrapped work on a Boeing company contract for a kill vehicle, the tip of an interceptor that detaches in space and destroys the incoming warhead, due to technical design problems after spending $1.2 billion on the project. The Pentagon then decided to restart the contract process to gather bids for the whole interceptor. Lockheed, Northrop Grumman, and Boeing were the competitors. Boeing was knocked out of the competition in 2021. The latest decision indicates that Lockheed trumped Northrop Grumman to emerge as the winner. The Missile Defense Agency said the following as part of its announcement. MDA is confident in this decision based on the technical maturity of the solutions, objective contractor-provided performance data, technical rigor in the design development process, and early testing built into the program from the onset. The Next Generation Interceptor program will be worth about $17.7 billion over its lifetime, according to government estimates. The first interceptor is expected to be operational in 2028. According to written testimony by the head of the Missile Defense Agency, Lieutenant General Heath Collins, the NGI is currently in the technology development phase and will transition to product development in May. To start with, the United States plans to buy 20 interceptors and deploy them at Fort Greely, Alaska. It's to be noted that the companies were designing the new interceptor using digital methods meant to speed up the design process, enabling the build of hardware and starting testing earlier in the process. Both also invested in establishing bases in Huntsville, Alabama, to more easily coordinate with MDA on the effort. In 2022, Lockheed invested in a new missile system integration lab in Huntsville exclusively for the development of NGI. The company is thought to have spent $16.5 million to build the new 25,000-square-foot facility, which opened in 2023. Moving forward, Lockheed Martin's NGI team will focus on reaching the critical design review milestone in the third quarter of FY 2025, exploring opportunities to expedite the schedule. During this critical review, the MDA will evaluate the readiness for flight testing. Despite all the efforts, in a future that might not be too far, diplomacy may fail. Traditional adversaries such as North Korea and Iran are increasingly proficient in executing long-range ballistic missile strikes. North Korea actually has made significant strides. The country ruled by Kim Jong-un successfully tested the Hwasong-18 ICBM three times in 2023. Most experts, including those based in the U.S., have noted that it could potentially hit even the U.S. mainland. North Korea is also developing nukes. The modernization endeavors aimed at the GMD will guarantee that the system maintains its edge against evolving threats. So, Next Generation Interceptor is a crucial endeavor for the U.S. Actually, this is one of the most important defensive programs being undertaken. The victory provides a significant boost for Lockheed, especially following the United States' announcement of its intention to scale back F-35 orders and the Army's decision in February to halt the development of the future attack reconnaissance aircraft. It remains to be seen how NGI progresses.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.